Hello everyone, Wenzeltron here, and we're going to be playing Varian today on Heroes of the Storm. The main reason for this is because Varian is one of those heroes that was released and had a really, really dominant build in both competitive and non-competitive in his tank form, since he is a multi-class hero. And since then, his talents have been tweaked to now have a different form of the hero come into the forefront that is very, very strong, and I enjoyed it even before it received, not actually buffs really, but before it's now become the dominant build for his tank. But yeah, we're gonna give it a shot today. I've been enjoying it a lot in ranked, and I've also mentioned it a couple times in some of my previous videos. So yeah, thanks for joining me, and we're gonna get into it. Thank you all again. Alrighty, everybody, we've landed on Sky Temple. I was gonna say Temple Shrines, and that sounded really weird, but aww. I messed up my skin combo. I was using the other Logosh Varian skin with this mount, because it's amazing. Just, you know, for some role-playing. But anyways, we're gonna do a parry build today, so we're gonna get this level 1 town overpower. When parry blocks a hero-based attack, heroic strikes cooldown refreshed, and the next one does 25% more damage. So this allows Varian to actually be able to do some very meaningful damage with an auto-attack-based team, which they have a Vala and a Taranda, so we'll be pairing a whole bunch of attacks. We're going to go for a Nubarak here, but I got stunned, but it doesn't matter. He was body-blocked by our stitches, no problem. I was there a little late, but I wanted to explain some stuff to you guys. Varian, as many of you probably know, is he used to get a stun on Warbringer at level 4. And since then, the ability has been tweaked and changed to do different things. And long story short, the ability no longer stuns. It no longer has an improved slow. It just reduces the cooldown by 8 seconds, which makes it a 4-second cooldown. So it's pretty low. Cooldown for the most part. I'm gonna ping danger up top because there's no one soaking there. I dodged the stun, haha. So basically, there's really no reason to go the cooldown because they've been reducing the cooldown on charge. It used to be 16 seconds, so as long as Stitch's hooks. Cooldown, and they also been reducing that now twice, so it's fallen quite considerably. Ooh, the stacking of the stun there is pretty good. So we do have a Medivh, so my tankiness is going to skyrocket into the late game, which is pretty fantastic. Stitch's hook did hit a beetle, I think. I'm gonna wait for the stun. I feel like it's coming. Didn't matter. We are losing the soak because the Vikings are soaking every lane, I think, or do believe. Might die here. Whoa. Nice. The Ragnaros put the boulder the wrong way. I need to go back. Alright. So then, once we do hit level 4, they do have the Vikings, like I said, so this might be a little difficult for us. Middle is about 3/4, there's about 1/5 of the top one left. We think the same way. Looks like they had to put the Vikings back, but they're now a whole level ahead of us. We just hit level 4. So now, at level 4, I want shield wall, so this... For the duration of parry, I do not take any damage. So Varian actually winds up being a very good tank for anti-mage, and synergize as well with burst mages as well. So when you have a Chromie on your team, or you have a... I'm trying to think of who else. Chromie, Li Ming especially. Li Ming is a fantastic partner for Varian, just to line up all the stuns just with the charge slow. It's just amazing. Vala just got that kill. Uh-oh. Did I get hit by the spikes? I totally did. I was trying to dodge it, didn't work. Yeah, he hit me. That was silly of me. I kind of went in at low health. Shouldn't have even gone back. I should have just gotten health. But that's fine. There's still a level ahead of us. We're not soaking very well. We don't have as good of a soaking team as they do. And then the other thing they added for Varian is they now gave him his tanking ability or tanking roll numbers. So now you can figure out how much damage you actually are soaking, which is awesome. What else? I'm trying to pull the Viking into here just in case he's not controlling him well enough. Should be able to kill this Viking. Nope, he got out. Wasn't sure if he had the movement speed or not. Let's see. Varian is not a terribly good lane pusher. He can do okay with his heroic strike. I'm gonna give live by the sword. So this talent increases the duration of parry by 40%, so this synergy is really well at level 4. And then you get, if at least two hero basic attacks are blocked, it reduces the cooldown by 2 seconds. So, this allows you to stack up your parry very, very nicely. And it looks like the enemy team is doing their job by having the team rotate us four, which is unfortunate. Vala looks like she has to go back, so we are going to be down. They are still a level ahead of us, just like the Vikings are always. Very good Viking player. I'm gonna try not to overlap my parries with Medivh's shield. We had stitches on the point. Now Ragnaros has used his molten core, and they do have ultimates, so they're two levels above us. I have been cocooned. There we go, pushed him out. It's fine. But stitches was zoned into the point. Fortunately, Kasia has been taken out. Medivh is good. Alright. So we got out. We're still behind. Unfortunately, we do not have a lot of damage on our team. And we don't have 10. So that's basically why we lost that. They were able to zone us out with Ragnaros' being able to just buy time for the Vikings to get them to level 10. The Ragnaros did go for Lava Wave. Man, these Vikings soaking is just punishing us hard. The problem is our solo lane doesn't really exist where they have a really strong four-man to blow one of us up. Or we don't really have, I mean, our solo lane. Did I say that right? Yeah, I think I said that right. So now, excuse me, I'm going to go for taunt. And this gives me a 30% health increase and gain armor. So the problem before So I just got a double kill there. And we're gonna get the Siege Giants to push in lane. And just like that, we took a 3-level deficit and turned it into a 1-level deficit. Just by us getting level 10 and being able to lock down 2 targets. That was even with Vala in a cocoon there. So you can see how much damage I didn't take and how much I was able to push into the enemy team. Soon they shall pass in my glory. I would have gone in there had I read that well enough, but it's too late. I'm in this group with the team. So this is where Varian actually takes off. And he used to get a 60% health bonus, and then it slowly went to 50, then 40, then now 30, and then they gave him armor. So I think with the armor, it's just as good. It just reduces maximum HP, but gives you a percentage damage reduction in general. He's already pretty tanky even without the W build, so I think it just makes sense. It's pretty good, and it gives him a little bit more baseline protection against all incoming damage rather than just a health buffer like Stitches is. I should really get this, no problem. So we don't know where they are. Our KC is pushing top, so it's pretty good. We're about to hit 13. We should be able to get that fort. And we got all the shots there. We should rotate bottom. Looks like they're going to heal Rag. Okay, they got Rag. Should definitely go bottom. So I'm going to go for just Juggernaut. So they got it. She used Hunter's Mark on me. I was trying to bait her into me, which he has done really well. Just kidding, keep using my shields to not die. Oh my god. I had to go in focus mode there. You gotta defend this. I'm gonna go around the safe way because I don't want to die by the giant. I'm just getting back here. Whew. So our KC is actually doing a really good thing here. By split pushing, she's taking pressure off of us to be able to keep a level, like the deficit. And the good thing here is that Taronda actually falls off into the late game. Her early game is super strong, her sailing. But late game, she falls off really hard and it gives her a really hard time in keeping up with it. And there we go, Ragnaros was overextended, so we were able to capitalize on that positioning error. I think as long as we're not fighting around a Nubarak, we should be fine. His constant little interrupts would make our life insanely difficult. She's slow and she's dead. And the Vikings have all grouped up, and that's a triple kill. All of the Vikings are now dead. Return this game, peeps. Return this game, peeps. That was a big misplay on the Vikings' part. They should not have all been together. They did go play it again, and now that they're all dead, they cannot come back. Usually the goal is that you can keep the Vikings split, and then if one or two die, you use the advantage to go and then get them all back and then spread them out again. Stitches is zoning. Taronda is back up. I do have taunt. And there we go. Boss is easy. And we should steal this. I found a Viking. But I totally misread this, unfortunately. I thought we would want to get more lane pressure. Gonna put my... That's two Vikings dead. I'm just trying to zone for Arcacia. Ooh. Quad kill. Oh, Toronto got sprint. Boss is still pushing bot lane, and now we're up in XP for the first time in this entire match. So I misplayed, but we were able to recover. We only lost Stitches there. Pretty good. This boss should be able to take, oh no, just the front wall. We got it too early in the game scaling for it to do too much. There's one thing to know is that Lion's Fang is cute. Is actually pretty long. It's longer than you think it is for the most time. And you can actually cast it. It's all about reading it since it is a fast travel time. So you can actually read that and allow you to use the Q as a way of catching up to then stun or slow the enemy team enough to get to them. I'm gonna sit in this bush. That's a double kill on the Vikings. Stitches is here. Their entire team is here. So the play again has been used. Stitches needs to get out. Punting there. And there we go. That's a double kill on Vala. And Stitches did get a kill on the Vikings. Gonna go for Taranda now. And I got the charge. And a taunt. There we go. That's team white, baby. Whew. And only because I am doing this shield wall build will allow me to even contemplate pushing into this. Like, if any other hero, I would be so scared of continuing to fight at like 10-20% HP. Like, that is such a low health, and I'm not even worried about it, because as long as I'm getting basic attacked, I can continue to take damage, but I won't take any of that effectively. Okay, thank God. That just absorbed 800 damage. That's another kill on the Vikings. You gotta run. Woo! So I'm actually gonna go. No, I'm just gonna go Vigilance. Just gonna go Vigilance, and then I'm actually gonna back right now because I have no HP. So level 20, Varian has 5.4 thousand HP. Not a crazy amount, but by being able to take no damage, you effectively like double that. As you saw when Ragnaros used the Lava Wave, and it said I absorbed 800 damage. That's kind of crazy, like really crazy. Protecting Vala here. Ah! Oh, the helping hand is so real there. With Medivh, I am just so tanky. I have no shield charges left. So if he burrows, we're fine. We can bait this. Oh, Vala got me with the multi shot. It's okay. We're fine. Casey is gonna kill the Vikings. She missed the Q, got dodged. Nope, he's out. Olaf has a Murden-like regen ability, so if he's not taking damage in combat, he's fine. They need to back out. They're low and no mana. She's dead now. Oh, she's not dead now. Don't kill it. Don't kill it. Don't kill it. It's gonna. No, she'll be fine. Whew, she got out. So did Medivh. That was crazy. The fact that she didn't die is kind of insane. Casey got the bottom shrine, so that's fine. We got the most shots on the top. Find something else to fight over. They're probably at boss. Oh no, they're sealing our camp, apparently. Oh, he messed up his burrow! Can use my banner now, just so we have that extra sustain. Oh, bro, it was already off cooldown. That was fast. So the Vikings stole this camp here. We should kill them. Ragnaros is dead for 50 seconds still. Alright, they're not doing boss.
We think the same way.
So we're about a level ahead. We have catapults in two lanes. They still have no catapults. We should probably just chase the Vikings here. I don't know. There's Vala. There's one Viking dead. Rest of them are coming to us. And they're both dead. And they tried to waste their ultimate as they did that. Stitches got the hook. It's not good. Ragnaros is taken out. I've dodged Vala's ult. I don't have a taunt range. We might be able to end the game here. If we get another kill. Let's just get the shrine. Our team wants to get boss since there's two dead. We do have a lot of damage. Don't want Casey to die here. There we go. Was able to save Casey there from positioning. I'm gonna go get health. I'm only at 30% HP. Stitches should back out. Stitches stayed too long. Vala is in a cocoon, but we should be able to save her. And the start is real! We were able to secure that kill, no problem. Sprinting away, Tarunda is out. We got this shrine, and we'll be able to rotate top shrine too. So there's four shots going in right now. And we do have boss on core, and I think that's going to be game. We're very close to it. After we get this shrine. All right. And that's game, peeps. This is how you do Varian. Tank Varian for the win. That's a Viking dead. Arcasia did do a lot of work. Let's see, 78,000 damage. She cleared lanes like a boss. Chasing them Vikings down. I messed up my hair, it looks like a little bit. Awesome. She looks like Wonder Woman. That's the skin I used when I did my video too. Am I on here? No. Boo. I'll vote Casey though. 36 kills with our Medivh. Nice to see that Medivh players are getting a lot better. So, let's do some stats. So we got great jobs. You got 17 assists. Woo! Let's see. 4, 17, 2. Our Medivh didn't die at all. That's amazing. I only take 55,000 damage, which is not a crazy amount, but Stitches was just being the fat man that he is, up in it all the time. And then for talents, I just basically did full parry build in the beginning of the game. And then taunt because I think Colossus Smash can be viable, but the problem that it reduces your max HP doesn't help. And then 13, getting Juggernaut. Because they didn't really have any of the other ones. They didn't have a shield. They didn't have a really significant healer. So it didn't really matter there. And then Banner of Ironforge. This did get to tweak. It used to be 25% armor. And now it is only 20%. So that's okay. And then I went for Vigilance. Because they did have a couple auto attackers on their team. The Vikings are considered auto attack, I would say. So, yeah. Nothing too crazy here. Pretty straightforward, I would say, for Varian, excuse me. Alrighty, everyone, thank you all for watching, and that's gonna do it for Varian today, and his shield wall build. I really like this build, and I find it very, very fun to be able to outplay your opponents with the shield wall and taking extreme amount of damage, and then taunt is just allows you to lock down an enemy for a very, very long time, and it's fun. I just like the play, and it's not as annoying as like a blow-up comp, but it is still pretty, it's very similar to that. But it's just, I just like this playstyle and it's interesting. And you just have the ability to have a level of skill over your own sustain rather than having to be dependent on only your healer, as you can play around yourself and your teammates rather than being dependent on an ally and, somewhat carry in that way. So thank you all for watching yet again, and please don't forget to check out anything else on my channel and let me know what you think about Varian.